One of the topics that you often hear about in genetics is the nature versus nurture debate, and you more likely have heard about this in a psychology class. And this is asking the question of how much of our behavior is due to genetics and how much is due to the environment. And so I introduced the idea of a phenotype as some combination of the genotype and the environment. A psychologist would rephrase this as how much of your behavior is due to nature and how much is due to nurture. But when they say nature, what they're referring to is your genetics. And when they say environment, we're talking about how much nurture you got. So parents taking care of you, were you adequately fed, did you have friends, sort of all of these things that could happen in your environment that are not due to your genes. And so your textbook asks this question, is sperm from someone with a PhD better than sperm from someone who doesn't have a PhD? Would you be willing to pay more? This is a complicated question, but if you're saying yes, you are saying that yes, you think some aspect of getting a PhD, which is the phenotype in this example, there is some genetic component. Because a sperm bank donor is not going to contribute to the environment at all, so he would only be contributing the genotype. So it's up to you to determine whether you think that's significant or not. This has ramifications in the discussion about whether criminals can be rehabilitated or not. How much is committing crime due to your genotype, and how much is due to the environment? How much does putting children in daycare early affect them? For a long time, this was a piece of the nurture-nature debate. Now, at this point, a lot of women are working, and so it's not so much of a debate anymore because women are more often in the workplace. The main way that psychologists actually study this is by looking at twin studies. So if you have identical twins, then you know that their genotypes are identical, and any differences in their phenotype or behavior must be due to the environment. You may be waiting for me to tell you what the answer is to these questions, and I don't want to have an answer. Human behavior is complex. We certainly have genetics, we have our environment, and then we have the ability to make decisions. And so it's a complex interaction of all of these things, and it's not as simple as, oh, it's just a genotype or it's just the environment. Now, there's something called epigenetics, and this is relatively new research that shows that sometimes the genotype that is expressed can depend on the environment. So here what we're saying is that the phenotype is not due to just the environment plus the genotype. We're saying that there's an environmental component to which genotypes are expressed. So it could be that your phenotype is a result of the environment. It could be that it's due to a genotype, or it could be due to the fact the environment has turned off or on a specific genotype. And what this epigenetics idea suggests is that there's not a clear division between environment and genotype, that these two things are interacting in a more subtle way than we realize. And there's a lot of interesting research that maternal environment, so what's happening with mom as she's pregnant, can really affect what genes are turned on and off. And there's a variety of studies that have looked at these epigenetic effects. In this video, we'll talk a little bit about some of those basic epigenetics. This is one of the really fascinating growing areas of genetics research.